everyone! Welcome to a very special live stream, and I hope that you guys will really enjoy this one because this is going to be an especially special treat. I'm going to be live streaming a video game, which I don't really do, but you know what? Over the past couple of days and pretty much a whole week, I have been going through so much stress and I have been just very concerned about my dad. And today, the good news is that he was able to fully recover, and the operation was a huge success. So, yeah, everything went wonderful, and I thought maybe, you know, just to calm myself and to have a little fun tonight, I thought, you know what, I might as well live stream a video game. So right now, I'm just going to quickly tell everybody that I'm going to be live streaming tonight. So, let me just do that real quickly. Live streaming. Okay, I just posted that right on Twitter, so all of my Twitter followers can be able to check it out. Let me just quickly post on Facebook as well, and then afterwards we can get the game started. So other than that, how is everybody doing? Hi, I see Mr. Mario too. How's it going? Let me know if you guys can hear me okay. Let me know if, I'm pretty small tonight, but that's because I want to be able to, emphasize, what I'm going to be playing tonight. So, let me just pop that in right there on Facebook. There we go. So, yeah. Let me know how's everything going. Let me know if you can see me okay, and if you can, great. So, with that said, I am going to get started on my game of the day. Well, the only one that I have that I can actually play, so let me just pop this in real quick. There we go. So yeah, tonight I am going to be playing another Metroid 2 remake. This is going to be the, for those who already know what another Metroid 2 remake is, it is the fan remake of Metroid 2 The Return of Samus. Let me just make this a tad bit bigger. Let me just remove my webcam for just a quick second. There we go. Let me just put myself back in. And there we go. Let me just put myself a little bit small, like so. There we go. That should be good. Alright, so unfortunately I can't be able to see through the chat and play the game at the same time. So if you guys have any questions, then I probably won't be able to answer, so I do sincerely apologize. I will try my very best to see via my phone, so I'll try my best to answer as much questions as I can. Let me see who's here. Yes, I am a gamer, Pocketbook, and my dad is doing fine, and he just recovered from the surgery very well. Right now he's just in recovery mode, and yes, I ordinarily would be doing like live stream Q&As, but I'm saving that for December because it'll be the 5th year anniversary of Old School Lane, and I thought, you know, maybe a little something different tonight because I'm in the mood for some fun, and I'm sure that a lot of people are in the mood for some fun as well. So, I have done a few video game podcasts in the past. The more recent one we did was on Metroid, and a few months ago we had Milton Gousty, otherwise known as Dr. M64, and we talked about this fan game right here, which is called Another Metroid 2 Remake. And this is the remake of Metroid 2 The Return of Samus. And yeah, I think that with the introductions out of the way, let's get started. So I already defeated the game, so let's start a new one. Metroids. Numerous incidents in the past have brought to light the highly destructive power of these life forms, spreading fear across all known planetary systems. So yeah, this is basically a continuation of the first Metroid, in which Samus defeated Kraid, Ridley, and Mother Brain over at planet Zebes, and basically, now that Metroid became a huge threat, the Galactic Federation is talking about we should get rid of the Metroids once and for all. So they hired Samus to do so. And that is basically what Metroid 2 Return of Samus is about. Have I seen the Legends of the Hidden Temple movie yet? Not yet. I will see it tonight, as soon as I'm done playing through this. I'm not gonna beat the whole thing. I'm most likely won't even do a part 2. I just want to do something a little bit fun for a few hours, talk to you guys. So yeah, let the games begin. So yeah, as you can see right here, SR388 is a lot more lush and green than what the Game Boy presented. It was like really monochrome, but you know, to be fair, it was the Game Boy. So, but seriously, I mean, the game is absolutely spectacular. It's a lot of fun. I already mentioned in the Metroid podcast that Metroid 2 was like one of my least favorite games in the Metroid series, mostly because I just found it to be so incredibly non-linear. It was linear, and it was so easy to get lost. There was no map, and everything just pretty much was the same, and it pretty much got monotonous after a while. So with this, it's a huge, huge improvement, and it's a shame that Nintendo never really had a remake of Metroid 2. I know that they were talking about it when, I think it was one of the guys behind Metroid Prime, saw a trailer of Dr. M64 demo of doing another Metroid 2 remake. They were thinking about, like, we should do that, and they just never did, which is a shame. I think that Metroid 2 Return of Samus done by Retro Studios would have been really interesting. So yeah, basically, the game functions pretty much like the original Game Boy game. The layout's the same, the music's the same. There are many changes, which we will be delving into when we continue throughout the game. And one of the things that I do like about Metroid 2 is that you start off with 30 missiles as opposed to having like 0 missiles in the original Metroid. And, you know, pretty much every single Metroid pretty much every single Metroid, with the exception of maybe Metroid Prime 3. And I have to prepare for this boss right here. So yeah, if you haven't played the Metroid 2 yet, basically there are many different types of Metroids in the game. You have I think these are the Alpha Metroids, I believe. And they're very easy to defeat. You just go like that. Not much of a gamer myself, but I remember the character Samus from Super Smash Bros. Brawl. My brother and I used to play that game all the time on the GameCube. Oh yeah! I mentioned that in the GameCube Memories podcast about Super Smash Bros. Melee, and yeah, it was a lot of fun. I main Samus in Super Smash Bros. Definitely Zero Suit. I've really gotten accustomed to her gameplay. So yeah, that was a lot of fun. And let's see. Come on, jump up, there we go. Well, don't worry, if you feel like you're the only one in the chat, I'm sure that more people will be coming in. It's almost 6 o'clock where I'm at, so maybe people are just maybe finishing up homework or something, or maybe just getting back from work. So, I'm sure there'll be more people coming in. So yeah, haven't seen the Legends of the Hidden Temple movie yet, mostly because I've just mostly been in the hospital, but so I've been hearing surprisingly good reviews from it. It's great that the Legends of the Hidden Temple movie turned out as well as it did, because from what I've been hearing from people before the movie came out, they weren't expecting much of it. So if what I've heard is true, then I'm really looking forward to it. And I will be doing a podcast at Nixoncast Podcast with the admins talking about the movie. There we go. Let's see. Yes, I am playing another Metroid 2 Remake Super Gamer 61499. It's a really great game. And I am a huge fan of the Metroid series. If you haven't checked out the Metroid franchise podcast that I did with Jim and Lily a few months ago, as well as interview Dr. M64 himself, I highly recommend you check it out. It's really good. It's still one of my favorite podcasts. Especially the Metroid franchise one, because I've really wanted to talk about that game franchise for so long. I feel like it doesn't get as much recognition as Mario or Zelda, and I still think it's really stellar in its own right. Okay, scanning the environment. Currently, there are 4 Metroids in the area. And I really like these little red creatures right there. They kind of look like Samus's helmets. I find it to be kind of cool. Maybe that's where the Chozo got the inspiration of making Samus's helmet look like that. I mean, they did create the Metroids, after all. So they can stop the X-Parasite, which, that story would continue in Metroid Fusion. Another one of my favorite games, Metroid Fusion. Okay, I believe that we're supposed to go down here. Yeah, where? Legends of the Hidden Temple movie didn't pull in as many viewers as I thought it would, only 1.6 million. Rufus pulled in 3.1 million. That wasn't highly participated as the Legends of the Hidden Temple movie was. That's too bad. I guess maybe people had low expectations for it, that they didn't really get a chance to see it, or maybe it wasn't advertised enough, I'm not sure, but trust me, I mean, if people know more about the reviews on Legends of the Hidden Temple, then I'm sure they'll have a chance to see it. I believe it is on sale on iTunes for $9.99, so maybe the sales will pick up on that. Come on. There we go. So yeah, forgive me if I'm getting a little lost. I haven't played this game since I beat it a few months ago. I'm probably a little bit rusty. So, I'm not a speedrunner, I'm not a completionist, I'm just a, you know, I'm just a regular gamer. Just not too hardcore, but not like casual, in which I say like Tetris is in like my top 3 or something. Well, I mean, Tetris is a good game, don't get me wrong, but I mean, it's not like, you know, that's like one of my all-time favorite games of all time. I mean, it's just a good game, though. Okay, I believe... let's go down here. Yes. Yes, we're supposed to go through here. Yeah, what we need to do is we need to get the Morph Ball. Destroying these things right here. Okay, granted, I live in Canada. I couldn't watch it, but when it's available in Canada or someone uploads it on YouTube. Let's see. Yeah, I'm hoping that it'll air in Canada. I definitely think that maybe the views will be a lot more higher. Let's see, my favorite Metroid game is Metroid Prime on the Prime Trilogy Collection for the Wii, although I have played another Metroid 2 remake and Super Metroid. Yeah, all great games, by the way. My favorite of the Prime Trilogy has always been the first one. The third one is second. The second one I'm not too crazy about. I always felt like it was trying to be like Link to the Past, which is not a bad thing, of course not, but I just didn't feel like Metroid. Ouch. And also, I just felt that the difficulty was just way too much. There we go. Got our first E-Tank. Which, you know, a lot of people... I mean, when I was in the PlayStation Let's Play channel, they would always joke about... Hey, you got an E-Tank! I mean, every time that I either play Metroid or Mega Man, it's like, yes, thank you, I got an E-Tank, now shut up! I would say that to Nick a lot. Because they always assume that I just can't collect E-Tanks. I don't know where that joke came from, but I just thought it was pretty silly. Okay, we're now gonna get the spider ball right here. Yeah, so the Spider Ball was introduced in Metroid 2, and unlike the Spider Ball from the Metroid Prime trilogy, you can be able to cling into any wall that you want, unlike in the Prime Trilogy in which you have to do it through magnetic walls. So it's really, really useful for climbing in, for crawling through every single wall, so you can be able to find missiles and E-tanks, and you can be able to progress through the remaining stages. Very helpful. And you can see from this Metroid shell right here that there is a Metroid up here, so we need to get up here with the spider ball. So yeah, if you guys have any questions or comments about anything, yeah, then please share. Okay, here we go. Okay, just three more to go. We got some more messages. Did you see the Nick Alive blog spot, the 2012 Nick series that will be ending after season 5? No, I have not. Oh yeah, I missed out. 1, 2. Oh, hold on. What was it again? I think it was 1. Okay, this one. This one. This one. There we go. Got it. Let's see, what is your favorite video game, or who is your favorite video game character? Super Metroid and Samus Aran. So, yeah, I'm a massive Metroid fan. The reason why, I mentioned in my Metroid franchise podcast about why Super Metroid's my favorite, but I guess I could say it again. The reason why is because I never played a game like the Metroid series, especially Super Metroid. I remember when I was 7 years old, and my cousin rented it from Blockbuster back when that was still a thing. And I was already familiar with the first Metroid game because, my cousin, as well as my teacher from school, she had an NES. They both had NESs. And I was already familiar with the Mario series and Legend of Zelda and Punch-Out and a whole bunch of those games, but Metroid was, it captivated me. It was something completely different, and when I saw Super Metroid, I was really enthralled by it. And I didn't fully complete the game until I was in high school, and then there were so many things about it that I just absolutely loved, and I became a huge fan of the games ever since. I didn't play Prime until a few years afterwards, but I was really invested into it. I remember that a lot of people didn't like the direction that Prime was going because it was going to be a first-person perspective, but it really worked out in its favor. And then I played throughout the rest of the series, and yeah. I played Fusion, and I played Zero Mission as well. Zero Mission was my favorite out of the handhelds that came out in the early 2000s. Yeah, I really liked them because with Fusion it had the best story, and with Zero Mission it was able to take a game like Metroid and update it, and it's probably one of the best remakes that ever came out. In fact, there's practically no reason for you to play the original Metroid because there are some things about it that are a little bit dated by today's standards. Let's see. Prime 2, from what I know of the Prime Trilogy Wii collection, did fix up the difficulty of the balance a bit. I have never played the Wii version, so I definitely will have to check it out. Because I've only played through the GameCube version, so I remember when the Prime Wii version was, like, really rare and expensive, so I never had the chance to pick it up, but I think it's gotten a bit cheaper since then, so who knows, maybe in the future I will pick it up. There you go. Get out of there! There you go. There we go. Let's see, what is your favorite video game franchise that you have played? Mine is Mario, because it was the one that got me into gaming as a whole. I believe that I did mention that Metroid was my favorite video game franchise, but there are a lot of franchises in video games that I really did love, especially the ones that I've done in podcasts, like Ratchet & Clank, Sly Cooper, Jak and Daxter, Mario, yeah, there's lots of them. Oh, I didn't even bring out my missile, so I probably would have been dead if I wasn't prepared. Not very easy to look through chats and playing at the same time. I don't have an option on my streaming software so I can be able to play and look through chat at the same time, so I apologize. Oh, I'm out of missiles. I have to get out. I wasn't even paying attention, so sorry about that. Yeah, you can't defeat the Alpha Metroid without missiles, which it kind of sucks. So, yeah, I'm gonna have to go back and save. This is what happens when you chat and when you play at the same time. Especially if you've done it for the first time. Okay, according to a blog on Nickelive, TMNT might be ending after Season 5. It's on Season 4 right now. Well, if it is, then it's had a really good run. It's been running for almost 4 years, or over 4 years at this point, and it's gotten really good. I mean, the most recent episode, episode 100, where April was going out of control with being controlled, it was like, that was really touching stuff, and it was pretty awesome, I have to say. And I know Cironelli, you know, he does a lot of great work with, like, Teen Titans and a whole bunch of the other shows that he's been a part of, so if he does plan on ending it in Season 5 and he wants to move on to other things, then good for him. Good for him. Alright, take two. Come on. Get up. Having really much difficulty with this one. This is what happens when you don't play with a controller. I have to play this with a keyboard, which kind of cripples my hands a little bit, but I have no other choice at this point. I need to really invest on getting myself a controller, especially one for Steam. I have a Steam account. Yeah, let's try this again. This would be a lot easier. I'm going to stay through here because I already have enough health that I can be able to sustain myself, so. There we go. That was much better. Oh yeah, that's right, I don't have the charge beam yet, so I have to go through it the manual way. Oh well. Let's see if I got some more. You guys are talking amongst yourselves. It's awesome. Please keep yourselves company while I try to beat this game the best of I can. I got a question. Are you a Mario Kart fan? Yeah, I like Mario Kart. I remember when I played Super Mario Kart on the Super Nintendo. That was a lot of fun. I haven't played a lot of Mario Kart games. I've only played Super Mario Kart, Mario Kart Double Dash, Mario Kart Wii, and most recently, I believe the most recent one was either Mario Kart 7 or 8. I played it in a convention a couple of months ago, and that was a lot of fun, playing with four players, and the new levels are really, really nice looking, like really nice looking. Let's see. Okay. If you want to get the Prime Trilogy for cheap, there's the eShop. You can get it for $20. Oh, yes, I can.
Okay, boss time.
Now, this boss wasn't in Metroid 2. This is a completely original boss, which is fantastic because the only bosses that you fought pretty much in Metroid 2 were the Metroids, and you had the Queen Metroid, so there wasn't a lot of variety with bosses. One of the things about this boss, though, is that you can't really dodge his projectiles when you're close in like this, so you have to be really careful. But he's pretty easy. There we go. Yeah, give me that. So yeah, as you can see right here, all of the lava has disappeared, and now I can be able to go more deeper into the level. Which is good, because the more Metroids that you kill, for some reason, a huge earthquake happens, and you can be able to go through the rest of the stages, which I still have no idea how that works. When you kill Metroids, the lava goes down. I have no clue. Leave a comment if you actually know why that happens. Let's see, I got some more questions. Oh, okay, good. You're talking about yourselves. Let's see. Have I seen Stranger Things yet? I've only seen like a couple of episodes, but I haven't really delved too deep into it because that was around the time my dad was getting sick, and I didn't want to watch anything too dramatic. I've heard some really good things about it. My sister was watching a few episodes of it. I think she finished the first season, and she said it was pretty good. So I really need to check it out for myself now that things are a lot more situated with my dad recovering in the hospital. I can probably watch. Oh, I always forget about that one. Get down from there. There we go. Okay. And this is actually one of my favorite songs in this entire soundtrack. If you haven't listened to the soundtrack yet, please, please go listen to it. It's on YouTube, and Milton did a spectacular job with it. The soundtrack on the original Metroid 2 was so incredibly bland and forgettable, and really painful at times because nothing but a bunch of beeps and boops and just... it was so draining. I mean, don't get me wrong, I do love listening to video game soundtracks on the Game Boy. I mean, Pokemon's a great example on that, but Metroid 2's soundtrack, nah. I would prefer listening to the more modern version with another Metroid 2 remake. It's definitely a lot more pleasing to the ears and it's a lot better quality. Alright. Come on. There you go. Maybe that was a little bit overkill, but whatever. I can always get more missiles. Okay, here we go. Here's the next one. Come on. Oh, I hate when that happens. Oh, there you are. I was wondering where you went. There we go. Oh, there we go. There. Yeah, so this is the Hydro Station, which wasn't in the original Metroid 2. So yeah, this is a really, really nice place because it gives a lot more variety to the locations. The locations in Metroid 2 were pretty much the same. There was some variations, but it was kind of a little hard to kind of see. And yeah, the problem with Metroid 2 was because it was on the Game Boy, they had to deal with a lot more strict limitations, so they had to basically just reuse a lot of assets. I'm just gonna run through here so I can get my next power up. Through here again, I think. Oh, that's how you do it. There we go. Got it. Yeah, you're gonna need a lot of missiles for this game because when you go through the remaining Metroid, like the Zeta Metroid and the Queen Metroid, they take a lot of missiles. Like, so many missiles that you won't believe, and even still to this day, I'm still having difficulties defeating the Zeta Metroids because they take so much health, and they have this erratic pattern. I sometimes hate you, Milton. but no, seriously, I love you, man. If they're even watching this. Let me just take a little break. I have to be careful with my health and trying to run low. There we go, much better. Okay, I need to time this just right. Come on. I always have difficulties with this one. Because you need to turn on. Let's see, I'm trying to wall jump and I'm trying to use the spider ball at the same time, so. Let's see if I can try it here. Oh! Well. I'll just get that later. Alright, there we go. Alright. Okay, let's try this again. Take two. There we go, got it. Let's see. And another Metroid 2 remake is pretty much what I would expect for a remake, and more. It's a shame that Nintendo won't endorse it because of copyright reasons. Yeah, it's a shame. It pretty much went through a cease and desist the moment that the game came out. But I was really surprised that Nintendo didn't do a cease and desist much sooner because, you know, Dr.M64 pretty much posted a lot of demos and trailers and everything. So they could have stopped it much sooner, but I guess, you know, I guess they just didn't. I don't know why. But regardless, we were able to get another amazing game from it. And the sad thing is that another Metroid 2 remake is not even being nominated for, like, best fan game, I believe. Same thing with Pokemon Uranium, which I've never played that before. So I don't know if that game is, I don't know if that game is, like, really good. I haven't checked it out yet. Let me see. Okay, pull that up. Alright, now things should be a lot easier because I have the high jump boots. Oh boy, Shamix, look, I know you're trying to be promoting yourself and that's really cool, but if you continue to spam like that, I will block you, and I don't really want to do that, so please be respectful for the viewers. I'd really be appreciative. Alright, there we go. There we go, that should be better. I fell. course I did.
Okay, there we go. That should be better now.
Okay, let me just add up a little bit. Ugh. Of course I fell down, because why wouldn't I? Okay, there we go. Okay, get your way. Can't fight you right now because I'm not in the best of health. Okay, let me just go there. There we go. Oh, that's right. I have to go from above. And now I'm trapped because of this stupid robot. Perfect. 10 out of 10, Patricia. You're the best. Oh, I don't want to die here. Oh, no. I have to do all that over again. Oh. Damn it. Oh well. Gotta shake myself and do it again. Okay, here we go. Take two. Ah, I thought you could do that to me again, huh? Come on. We fought you already. We need to fight you again. There we go. Okay, lure you away. You know what? I'm just gonna go here first because let's have a little different scenery. I'll get the rest of the stuff later. There we go. So yeah, let me just go through here first. Go up. There we go. So yeah, you need to be able to get through up there. There we go. Okay, now things will be a lot easier because now I have the wave beam. Maybe I should have done that sooner. Stuff like that is slowly but surely killing them. Yeah, unfortunately, you know, with Nintendo not giving full trust with their fans, it does kind of detriment them. Like, for example, Christian Whitehead, who's the guy who created the fan Sonic game, and eventually he did like a whole bunch of awesome phone ports for the Sonic series, Sonic 1, 2, and Sonic 3 and Knuckles. And look where he's at now. He's creating Sonic Mania. So yeah, people who do fan games can go off and have successful careers helping out the companies that they were inspired by in their own right. So yeah, that's much better. Take that, robots. Seriously, why didn't I do this sooner? I feel like a jerk. Okay, so going down. There we go. Have you seen the sneak peeks from Pinky Malinky yet? Nickelodeon uploaded a montage of funny clips to their YouTube channel. Yes, I have seen it. It looks interesting. I'm not gonna really say too much about my full opinions yet, but it does look pretty interesting. Let's see if I can get those. Because I don't have the charge beam, I can't be able to grab those, which is another great addition that Dr. M64 was able to make into another Metroid 2 remake, in which, you know, similar to the Metroid Prime games, you can actually get the power-ups whenever they're up there by just using the charge beam. And similar to Metroid Zero Mission, if you charge up the charge beam, you can be able to have like a mini screw attack when you do a somersault. Alright, let's see if we can get those missiles again. Okay, there we go. Alright, now, let's try this again. Come on, you can do it. There we go. Gotcha. I'm sure the answer is no, but have you seen Welcome to the Wayne miniseries yet? No, I have not seen it yet. I will get to eventually. There we go. Get your butt that. Okay, let's hope I don't have difficulty trying to climb up here like last time. There we go. Going down! Oh, there it is. There's an XE tank. Okay, there we go. Now things are a lot... things are going to be a lot easier to deal with now. Come on! There we go. Yeah, I don't think... just for fun, why not? Yeah, I don't think you can be able to go through here. No, you can't. I'm heading out. Okay. Yeah, I think we're pretty much done here, so let's head out. You had to do that. Why wouldn't I expect you to not do that? Okay. Here, take that. Here we go. Going down. Okay. Next boss. Which kind of looks like, Chocobo, I mean, not Chocobo, wrong game, Chozo statue, but, yeah, this should look really familiar to those who've played Metroid Fusion. This was actually the first boss in the game, except it's a little bit different. I remember when I was playing through this boss and I was having difficulty, like, what am I supposed to do? But it turns out you actually have to do that. I remember when Lily and I, we were talking about this particular boss, we were like saying, this boss is difficult, what were we supposed to do? I must have died at least 10 times trying to figure that out. So yeah, it's a good thing that it's a lot easier to figure out, but the timing on this is a little bit difficult, so yeah. Okay, let's hope that I don't die here, because I do not want to do that again. I am definitely going to die. I am definitely going to die. I am definitely going to die. I am going to die. Of course I died. Alright. Oh, let's try that again. Well, unfortunately, we have to probably do that whole thing again. So, you know what? I'm going to just... So you know what, I'm actually going to go after the boss first, and then I'll go after the rest of the stuff later. So yeah, I'll probably do that. That way we can get the boss thing going. So I'm going to try again. Although it's going to be a little bit difficult now because I don't have the wave beam, nor do I have as much missiles as before, but I think we can be able to do just fine. Okay, I just save right there. Guess I should have done that in the first place. Yeah, that is true. You don't have to start from the very beginning. I mean, but then again, Metroid 2, the Return of Samus, also had checkpoints as well. So, yeah, there's a bright side to everything, I suppose. Alright, now let's see if I can actually defeat this thing. Alright, let's do this again. Yay! Jump! Ah, it's a little hard to find the timing for this thing. Gonna keep on doing that, aren't you? Of course you are. Okay, let's try this again. Okay. Starting to run out of missiles, which is gonna be real pain. We're running out of health, too. There we go. Alright, let me just get another drink. Okay. Okay, let's try this again. If I die the next time, I'll go back to the power-ups and I'll try to see if I can try to deal with it later. Alright, let's see if we can do this again. Okay, here we go. There we go. Okay, I think I may do this. Better not jinx myself. Alright, I'm gonna move over to somewhere else. Yeah, I really need to get those power-ups because I don't think I can be able to survive with just 2 energy tanks and only 45 missiles. Okay. No, it's not here. It's over here. Let me just go get it. Okay, got the okay, got that one. Just get another missile, which is right up here. Okay. The original Metroid on the NES, from what I know, hasn't aged that well. In fact, I've seen in TGC's video, it's quite a frustrating game. Yeah, it is a bit frustrating because you start off with 30 health points and you move very stiffly. There's no map, so it's very easy to get yourself lost and... Yeah, I would recommend that you do play Metroid Zero Mission instead. That's a much more better game. Okay, the reason why I'm crawling through this wall right here is not only to make the map more increased, but I also want to be able to scout through more secrets to see if there's any. There's not really around here, but I want to be able to get more through the map. It's definitely a lot easier. So there's actually an Alpha Metroid right here, so I might as well just take care of it right now. Okay, I don't think there's anything around here. I don't think there's any secrets here, so I'm gonna head out. Alright. Let's see. Yeah, I'm gonna save right here because I'm gonna have to go through that whole thing again, so... You know what? Might as well. So, let's see. Yeah, go to the left. Actually, let me just take care of this thing first. You know, just to see something a little bit different. There we go. Water down. It's a lot easier if you have the various suit. Oh, hold on. There we go. I mean, yeah, it's a lot easier if you have not the barrier suit, you have the gravity suit. That way you can be able to go through water much easier, but I don't have it, so in the meantime, I'll just have to take care of this. Okay, and there you are. There we go. Missing. Uh-oh, where could it be? Let's see if we can find it. Where is it at? Oh, that's right. It's true. I think it's supposed to be right above the Chozos. There we go. Thought it was there. Okay. Shoot through everything here. Get rid of all this stuff, and we should be able to get the various suit. There it is. If you didn't know about this fact, it's actually a mistranslation of the word barrier. So it was originally supposed to be called barrier suit, not various suit. So now we have the various suit, which is Samus's more iconic suit, because she has the round metal shoulders, which that will definitely be a lot easier to deal with in the boss, since it only takes about 50% damage. So that'll be a lot easier to deal with. Hold on just for a second. Let me see if I can just do this really quickly. Oh, hold on. Okay. Yeah. There we go. I thought so, because cracks on the wall means goodies. So let me just go through there. Oh, hold on. Yeah, let's see if I can try to go through there. Yeah, it's a bit of a puzzle here. Yeah, you have to aim it just right so you can be able to get the missile. Yeah. Could be a while until I get it. I think I may have gotten it. There we go, got it. Alright, I think we can get out now. Okay. Yeah, still having difficulties running through water. The gravity suit won't come in until a little bit later in the game. But I'm gonna try to see if I can grab that missile. It'll be a lot easier if I can grab it using the gravity suit, but I don't have the gravity suit, and it will be a lot. On. There we go. Got it. I believe it's right there. Okay. Okay, got it. Ah, my phone's dead, so I won't be able to read through the chat. I'll be right back. Okay, got my cord with me, so let me see if I can just plug this in real quick so I can charge my phone again. Okay, back to the game. So if I miss anything from the chat, I completely apologize. My phone died. I had no idea that it died, so I wasn't able to read through your questions or anything like that. But I hope that you're enjoying it so far. I'm having a lot of fun, so I hope you guys are having fun too. Oh, great. Okay, go up here. Here, just plug that out. I think it'll be okay now. Yeah, I'm not supposed to go through here yet, so I'm gonna leave for now. Hold on. There we go. Alright, let's try this again. Come on. Ha ha! Thought you can get me, huh? Not today. There we go. Alright, things should be a little bit more easier now. Okay, I'm gonna go through here first. Oh, Freely, you're gonna jump around? You're not gonna let me through? No? Guess what? Too bad. Okay, now things should be a lot easier again now that I got the wave beam. Okay, there we go. Okay, now we're starting to make some progress again. Hey, I'm back. Okay, I got the phone ready again. What are your thoughts on Metroid NES? Really good game for its time. It hasn't really held up, unfortunately, so I would recommend that you do pick up, Metroid Zero Mission instead for the Game Boy Advance. That is basically everything that made the original Metroid great, except that it's been tweaked a whole lot better. So. Okay, let me see. Most underrated show on Nickelodeon and Cartoon Network. I already mentioned like a bajillion times about As Told by Ginger, so yeah, As Told by Ginger, most underrated animated show. Most underrated live action show is Caitlin's Way. Cartoon Network, oh man, that's really tough because I'll definitely need to watch more Cartoon Network, that way I can be able to dive myself really deep into it, because it's been a while since I've watched all the Cartoon Network programs, but I really do like Chowder. I don't know why a lot of people didn't really seem to care about it when it first came out. I mean, granted, I didn't really, I was a bit too old when Chowder came out. I was probably, I don't remember when that show came out, it was probably either in high school or college, but because I love cooking, I really do love the fact that Chowder was able to make a whole bunch of jokes about different types of food and stuff like that. So, there's that. Any other shows on Cartoon Network? I don't really know, so I'll probably just say Chowder for now. Maybe there's a whole bunch of others. I know there's a lot of obscure ones like Mike Lou and Og and Squirrel Boy, which I've never really seen. So maybe they're underrated. I have no idea. I'll definitely have to look into it again to see my impressions on it. Alright, I'm heading out of here. down, get this high jump boots again. Like, I haven't done that like a bajillion times at this point. Let's see what else. What's one show on Nickelodeon do you think deserves to have one more season? That's a really good question. Let's see, one more season. I'm not sure. I think Danny Phantom, because there was supposed to be another season of Danny Phantom that was supposed to answer more of the questions, but because Nickelodeon wanted the show to be canceled, Butch Herman had to basically rush through everything, which is why season 3 is the way it is. And oh man, that season 3 is so rushed, like really incredibly rushed. We even complained about that a few years ago when we were doing the Danny Phantom podcast, that, you know, the fact that Nickelodeon wanted the show to be canceled, plus that Butch Hartman was having, you know, difficulties with writing the series ever since Steve Marmo left, it pretty much put a detriment onto him. So, yeah, Danny Phantom definitely deserved to have another season, just so it can be able to complete the story that he wanted. As opposed to, like, Nickelodeon say, Danny Phantom's not doing as well as, like, Fairly Oddparents, according to them. So we're gonna cancel this show. It's, like, great. Fantastic. Alright. Alright, you know what? I am not doing that again, by the way. I'm saving right now. So if I die, at least I'll die right there. I am not doing that collect-a-thon again. I am sorry. There we go, that's a lot more easier to dodge now that I have the high jump boots. It's always a pain to get this one up there, and we're done! Yes! Ah, finally! Defeated him! Hooray! And the sad thing is that you get the spring ball for defeating him, which, I mean, it's nice that I don't have to use missiles anymore, but still, it's kind of a bummer. But, hey, I get to bounce around. Why do I have to do that? Turn that off. Okay, save that, and we're done here. Oh, thank you. Ugh, that was such a pain. Okay, let's see. Where do we go next? Okay, I think I definitely do need to go to the left. If you have any other questions in the chat. Do you remember the last episode of Phantom Planet where Danny saves Danny and Valerie learn that Vlad is half ghost? Those 7 episodes could answer those 2 final cliffhangers where Danny's parents adopt Danny and Valerie gets revenge on Vlad. Yeah, that would be kind of interesting. Let's see. Yeah, I think we're okay.
see. Am I missing anything? Double check the map. I think I'm okay for now. Okay. New location. Finally. It's only been a couple of hours. Okay, let's defeat the last three Metroids once and for all and move on to somewhere else. Okay, let's do the first one. There we go, now I'm back. Did you get stuck or something? I don't know about that. That was pretty funny. There we go. Alright, I can either go left or I can go down, so I'm gonna go left. There you are. Hey, how's it going? So, hang around much? No? Okay. There we go. There's definitely a power-up around here. There it is. Yeah, I forgot to get that other E-Tang. I'll definitely have to get back to it when I have the chance. Let me just save really quickly. I don't want to have to go fight the other three Metroids again. I want to be able to get done and done with this place. Phone died again. Of course it did. Let me just get this a quick charge somewhere else. Alright. Let me just take a quick little peek at the chat to see if there's any other questions. Let's see, if you could have made sure one Nickelodeon show was never greenlit, what would it be? Well, there's plenty of them we've discussed about in Nick's Missile in the past, but definitely The Modifiers. I would have loved to have seen The Modifiers happen, because there was so much potential in that show. It's just too bad that it never happened. But seriously, there are so many shows that could have happened, but it never did, which it sucks. Okay, let's defeat the last one once and for all. Well, not the last one in the game. There's plenty of other Metroids in this game. I think it shows on the map right there. Right there on the bottom, 44 Metroids left, so we still have a long way to go. Okay, so you can see this one is a little bit different because it has legs. So this is kind of like a smaller evolution of the Alpha Metroids. So, trust me, we're going to be fighting off the other Metroids later on in the game, but... Come on. Come on. There we go. Alright, that's all of them. Now we can go somewhere else. Thank goodness. I don't know about you, but I really need to find... I need to... Oh, that's right, I forgot. Great! Yeah, so this is basically the... I believe this is the Zeta Metroid, or no, the Beta Metroid. So, yeah, these are a little bit stronger than the Alpha Metroid. They take a lot more damage, and they can shoot lightning. But if you time it just right, they're also really easy to take down. There we go. Alright, we're done with that noise. Okay. Yeah, earthquake. So, ordinarily, I'm supposed to go up, but I really want to get the other E-tank that I missed, so I'm probably going to take a little quick detour, and then afterwards we can continue with our regularly scheduled Metroid kicking, or shooting, whatever you want to call it. Now, where was it again? I think it was in the bottom? I believe it was. Let me just go down. I remember. Yeah, I think it was right here. No, I think this is where the other missile... Oh, that's right, I already got that one. Let me see if I can recall... No, I don't think this is it. Okay, let me see. Let me just take a look at the map real quick. See if it's in here. Yeah, I don't think I can recall, but I'm heading over this way anyway, so, because this is actually where we're supposed to go to next, so. Yeah, because the earthquake happened, I believe more part of this land has already been revealed, so I will do that. And now we can go down, like so. There we go, now we can go over to the next part of the game. Okay, scanning, and we have a total of 10 Metroids around here, so we're gonna be here for a while.
Okay.
Yeah, in order for you to get through this area, you need to have the speed booster. So we're not going to go through here just yet. I believe we have to actually go up. I really do hate this place right here because you have to do a lot of shooting down here. It would be a lot easier if I had the charging beam. By the way, if you're wondering, no, I can't kill these things in the bottom. Okay, space jump. Great. Oh, that's right, we have to fight the boss. This is actually a really awesome boss. If you haven't played through this game, it's really interesting. Definitely kind of reminds me of the mechanical Chozo creature that you fight in Super Metroid. Very unique kind of boss. I'm so gonna die. I am so gonna die. Yep. Alright, well, let's try that again. Go.
chat. How is my dad doing? My dad's doing much better. The surgery was a complete success, and right now he's just resting. So that's why I am home, and yes, I am playing Metroid 2. More specifically, I am playing another Metroid 2 remake, created by Dr. M64. So yes, if you're just joining us, welcome. And I keep forgetting that I don't have the space jump anymore. Alright, you know what? I might as well just do this really quickly. Why not? Because more missiles are your friends. Alright, so yeah. So, alright, let's try this again. Okay, some water. Okay, let's try this again. That was a lot easier. Okay, now there we go. There we go! Yes! Finally defeated it! Ah, oh, what a relief. There we go. Yeah, I don't think there's anything else around here, so let's get out of here. Okay, got a missile.
Okay. Yeah, if you're wondering, no, that boss actually never appeared in the original Metroid 2. That was a completely original boss, once again done by the talented Dr. M64. Oh, got another Beta Metroid! Because of course we do. Come on, get down here. Let's see. My last question, what's the one Nickelodeon show that was greenlit that did become a show that you would have made sure wasn't greenlit? Fanboy? I mean, seriously, after what Fanboy and Chum Chum eventually became, I mean, I don't know if that really deserves to have been picked up over Adventure Time, but then again, Adventure Time is something completely different than what Nickelodeon did with random cartoons. I may even do a From Pilot to Final Product in the future about the Adventure Time pilot because it is so different than what it would later become in Cartoon Network. But yeah, I mean, I am definitely going to be doing more From Pilot to Final Products on besides Nickelodeon shows, so yeah. So, I'm really looking forward to doing one on Adventure Time. Because I really have a lot to say about that one. Okay, I think the speed booster is in here. Yes, it is in here. Perfect. So yeah, this is actually one of my favorite power-ups in the game. Doing the speed booster, and then afterwards doing the shine spark. So let me see if I can attempt on doing that. So yeah, maybe not this one, but I'll definitely do that more down the line. So yeah. Yeah, you definitely need to do the shine. You need to speed boost right here, so let me just kill this thing first. Okay, there we go. Okay. Well, that's right, I have to get rid of these things first. Okay, so. This thing. I don't need to set that here. There we go. Alright. Yeah, because you have to get up here. Okay, let's try this again. There we go. Okay, so... since Nick's Missile 4 is going to be about dropped Oh Yeah Cartoons pilots, is Nick's Missile 5 going to be about the dropped Random Cartoons pilots? It could be. We haven't decided about what Nick's Missile 5 is going to be about. So, yeah, maybe we'll put that on the list for a possible Nick's Missile 5 in the future. And let's see, how did I get the idea of Nick's Missile 4, because it's a great idea. I've been wanting to do one on Oh Yeah Cartoons for quite some time, and since Oh Yeah Cartoons was basically a TV show about nothing but pitched pilots, I thought it was perfect. And, you know, to be quite honest, Oh Yeah Cartoons is definitely one of the least talked about Nicktoons of the 90s, So I thought, you know what, I think it would be perfect for us to talk about it, because I don't think a lot of people online really get in depth into discussing about OEF cartoons, especially with all of the OEF cartoon shorts. I know there have been a handful of people who have talked about OEF cartoons, like maybe one or two of their favorite pilots that they wish that they could have happened. Like the cartoon hero, he recently did one on Enchanted Adventures. But as we're looking at every single one of them, and there are, you know, in total, there are 99 OEF cartoons pilots. So, I mean, other than the ones that eventually did get picked up, like The Fairly Odd Parents, and Chalk Zone, and My Life as a Teenage Robot, all the other ones don't really seem to be discussed on as much. So yeah, we've been wanting to do one on OEF cartoons for quite a while. We were just waiting for the right moment. And I thought that, you know what? I mean, since we did one on the basic rejected or canceled pilots, and since we did one on the TV shows that eventually moved over to other networks, and then we did the movie, so I thought, you know what? I think it's about time that we did talk about OEF cartoons. It'll be so much easier if I had the screw attack here. So I can be able to take down these robots. Ouch. Ah, there we go. Get up. Oh, really like lava. Right, get up. There we go. Okay, 2 down, 8 to go. I better get to a safe state pretty soon, or else I'm gonna have to do that whole thing all over again. Alright, get out of there. Go away. Alright, there we go. Okay, now we're gonna do this little thing right here, which is gonna be a lot of fun. We actually get to control some of these little things. So yeah, this was actually never in the original Metroid 2, and I thought this is actually a pretty cool idea. You actually get to control this robot, and you have to destroy these walls so you can be able to continue on throughout the remaining stage. But you have to be careful, because if you don't avoid these mechanisms, you're going to get crushed. Ah. Damn it. Alright, let me try that again. Okay. Yeah, you can also control your jump as well. Even though that I see missiles there, it only picks up super missiles. So, yeah. I guess it makes sense because super missiles are basically the equivalent of 5 missiles at once. So it's a lot more stronger. There we go. Okay, that's one. Now I just need to do the other side. I think we're done here. Okay. Okay, hopefully... Yes, the super missiles are actually right here, so perfect.
Okay. Anyway, hopefully I can get to a save state pretty soon, because I'm pretty weak. I'll have to go back up there, and hopefully I don't die.
Gotta get up! Come on! Almost there! Come on! Woo! Made it!
Okay, where to next? Right up there. I think I'm done exploring this area, so I'm gonna go up and to the left now. Well, that's right, I can't escape through that way. It has to be through the other way. Yeah, it's up here. And I have to... Yeah, it's up here. See if I have any other questions in the chat. Let's see. Did you know that Disney tried to make their own show, like What a Cartoon, and Oh Yeah Cartoons? It was called Shorty McShort Short. Unfortunately, one pilot got a full series on the Hub. I've heard of it. I have never seen it. So, yeah. Sorry. Okay, going to the left now. Come on, let me go through. There we go. There we go. Okay, where was it at again? I know it's around here somewhere. I think you have to bomb somewhere. I think it's somewhere down here, but I don't remember where it was. Oh, of course it was up there. I knew it was up there. Okay. There we go! Okay. Only a few more to go. Got another E-Tank. Oh, well. Yeah, I think we're supposed to go through here. Yeah, there we go. Okay, we're gonna keep going. Thank you.
Okay. Let's see if I'm missing anywhere around here. I think I'm okay through here because I got the speed booster, which means I could be able to go through where I wasn't supposed to go through last time. So I'm gonna head out of here. Okay, so I believe we have to go up. And we're going down. Okay, the spacer beam. Now things will be a lot more doable now that my range has widened. Yeah, it'll be a lot easier to shoot down these things as well. Okay, I don't know why I can't shoot through that for some reason. Okay, I'll just save through here. Okay, let's see. It was re-greenlit because it was rejected in 2006. I'm not sure which one you're referring to. Probably there was that pilot that you were talking about from the hub on the Shorty McShort Shorts one, so... That's probably what you're referring to, I assume. Okay. Okay, so I'm just... Yeah, I think there, yeah, there was only one of them. Ah, I went back. There we go. Okay. Yeah, I think... Okay, we're starting to move things along now. There's another one. Okay, perfect. Okay, we need a few more to go. Let's see. If you guys have any other questions, then please let me know in the chat. Anyway, so, while I'm trying to look for the next Metroid, I guess I could talk about, a couple of things. Let me know what you want me to talk about. I can talk about, the next couple of videos for the year, or maybe next Missile 4. Let me know what you want me to, go in more detail about, especially, since This is a pretty long game. Well, I mean, it's not super long, but, you know, considering that I haven't played it in a while and I'm not really too much of a speedrunner, I could be here for maybe a few hours. I'm probably not gonna complete everything. I might not even finish the game, but just something I wanted to do just for a little fun. I'm trying to complete this map right over here. I probably need to go a little higher. There we go. Ah, of course. The power bomb. I don't have that yet, so I'm not gonna be in this room for a while. Okay, let me just look through the map really quick. Let's see. Okay, I already went through there. Okay, I'm probably gonna go through that hall, go down, and head over to the right. You know, I'll probably do that. Probably where the last remaining Metroid are. If you could voice any cartoon character, who would it be? Oh, wow, that's a really good question. I have no idea. I never really considered myself to be a voice actor. I think the only time in which I have attempted of trying to do that was when I was doing the audio plays for Manic Expression, and they needed some female voice actors, and I did do a few voiceover roles. You know, especially since there weren't a lot of women in the site at the time. So, those were a lot of fun. But, man, who would I voice? That's a really good question. I guess I have, like, maybe two particular characters that I've always wanted to voice. Like, if I ever wanted to voice for anime, I've always wanted to voice either Yomi or Sakaki from Azumanga Daioh, because those two are my favorite characters in the series. I mean, don't get me wrong, I love all the remaining characters, but I don't know if I can be able to match their voices really well. Like, if I was Chiyo, I have to be, like, really cute all the time, and that's definitely not my voice. If I was, if I was Tomo, oh my gosh, I have to do tons of screaming and hyperacting. The same thing if I was Yukari Sensei. Probably Tanizaki Sensei would also be somebody that I would voice to, because I'm more calm than anything. Kagura would be alright. I mean, you know, she's the athletic type, so you know, she'd be probably a lot of fun. I don't know if I can do Osaka. Osaka would be like really low and slow and kind of a little dim-witted, so, oh, hold on. As for American, I have no idea. Yeah, I never really see myself as, like, a voice actor. Ouch! Let go of me! So yeah, I mean, I might do Samus very well, but I don't know. I mean, I always picture Samus as, like, very stoic and very calm. Basically what Jennifer Hill did for Commander Shepard, I would imagine that for Samus. But yeah, because You know, Jennifer Hale did do the voice of Samus in the Prime series, but she did, like, you know, screams and grunts and stuff like that. So I don't know if, you know, she could probably do her Samus voice, I mean, her Commander Shepard's voice as Samus. That would be pretty much the same, in my opinion. I mean, I would like to see somebody else try to voice Samus, but yeah, I'm at this point, I'm not sure. And yeah, if this part in the game is going to be a little bit dark, so my apologies. Come on. Okay. Okay, if I think what is around here, what I think it is, then I'm gonna be... Oh, no, not yet. Okay, good. It's just the Beta Metroid. I thought that the Zeta Metroid would be in here, but not yet. Good. Because I don't think I would fight the Beta Metroid until much later in the game, but I do know that at points it does come a little sooner. Come on. There we go. Okay, just three more, and they're actually towards that spiky area, so... Yeah, I just need to take them down, and then we can finally go over to the next area. Let's see... Yeah, I think they're... Yeah, they're up there, so let me just get up there. Okay, you could voice Ren from Adult Party Cartoon? I don't know. I don't know if I would do a really good Ren impression. I mean, if I have to do a Ren impression, it'll probably have to be a really old, really tired Peter Lorre, which, you know, I don't think it was intentional for John Chris Felicio to voice like that. I guess because he hasn't done the character in a while, it kind of is a shame that he was able to not pull him off just the way he did, like, over 10 years ago. Anyway, so I think I do need to go this way. Yeah, I have to go up. Let's see. Okay, well... No, I guess it's not that way. I thought it wasn't that way, yeah. No, it's not that way either. I already went through that way. I think... Let's see if I remember correctly. I know it was around here somewhere. This way. Yeah, I think I need to go down. Yeah, I did need it to go down. I was right. Yeah, this is going to be a little bit hard to see because it's really dark. Oh, there it is. There we go. Definitely need to get some more missiles somewhere. I only have a few missiles left, and I don't even see a save state around here. There's two left. Yeah, I probably have to do a little bit of farming, so... Yeah, ask me anything in the chat while I do that. Because I don't want to bore you guys to death. Let's see. I meant the OG Ren, aka from the Ren and Stimpy show. I don't think so. I don't think I can pull off Ren. I mean, maybe a really bad impersonation of Ren, but I don't think so. Yeah, I'm gonna collect just a few more, and then afterwards we can start getting the last two Metroids. Yeah, just one more. There we go. I should do the trick. I am supposed to go right. Okay, there we go. Definitely around here somewhere. There it is! Come on, get off of me! There we go. Where are you? There you are. Okay, one more to go. Thank you. Okay. Now I need to get the last one, which is around here somewhere. Yeah, I think it's this way. No, it's not this way. It's a little hard to see when it's all dark. Now that did I watch the Double Dare special, and what did you think of the Legends of the Hidden Temple movie? I did see the Double Dare special. It was really good, and I'm really glad that it did turn out pretty successful from what I saw on the Slime Facebook page. And who knows, maybe it'll be possible for a Double Dare revival with Mark Summers in it. I have not seen the Legends of the Hidden Temple movie yet. I will get to it at some point. I probably tonight, as soon as I'm done live streaming through this. As if I remember where the last Metroid was. Let's see. Looking through the map. It's definitely around here somewhere. No, I already went through here, so I'm gonna leave. Kind of hard to see when it's all dark. No, okay, now I remember. It was this. I think it was this one, was it? Was that? No, that's where I was already at. Oh, there's a super missile here. Okay, there we go. That should be easier now. And I wasted it. Of course I did. Good job. Okay, let me get another one. Okay, let's try that again. Okay, there we go. I was supposed to get to it. Not gonna make it easy, but I'm done here. I think I'm supposed to go up somewhere. Let me see if I'm supposed to go up here. No. I think I need to go to the next room. Thank you. I think it was supposed to, I think it was definitely in the other room. Let's see. Now that I thought an adult Ren and Stimpy show was not a bad idea, the only problem is that it was executed horribly, not to mention the humor was forced. Yeah, there's been a lot of debate on whether it was Spike TV or whether it was John Chris Belushi that really wanted the humor of Ren and Stimpy to be the way it was. It's still up for debate. But, yeah, I mean, I wasn't really too crazy about it. I really don't care for Ren and Stimpy adult party cartoon. It was definitely one of the biggest mistakes in John K's career. One of the biggest mistakes is that, you know, I always hate it when I have to search through this place and I just never find out where the last one is. I know the last one is around here. Again. Yeah, let me try to see if I can go right. Oh, I missed something. Alright, I'm gonna probably assume that I may have gotten them all. So I'm gonna head out. Wow, I am such an idiot. It was this way the whole time. Next time, check on your map, kids, to find out where you're supposed to go in video games. There we go. Finally, we're done here. Cheers to that. Thank you. and here we are back where we started. Oh boy, that was tiring. Okay, let's see. What is my favorite band? Oh man, I have a lot of favorite bands. Let's see. There's Polaris. They Might Be Giants. Let's see. When I was a kid, I really did like listening to the Red Hot Chili Peppers band, but their stuff is just not as remotely interesting as it was back then. I also like, let's see, there's Green Day, there's a lot of bands. Yeah, there's a lot of bands that I can say. Not really too crazy on heavy metal because it's really sensitive to my hearing. But yeah, there's a lot of bands in it. Okay, I want to definitely remember this spot in the future because you're actually supposed to shoot a power bomb right over here and it can lead you up to a secret laboratory. So, let me see if I can remember this part on the map. Yeah, let's see if I can definitely remember. Okay, so yeah, this is when things start getting a little bit suspicious, because right over here are the dead Galactic Federation soldiers. And they definitely look like the ones that you see in Metroid Prime 2. Okay, so you get that. And right over here is where we see our next form of... Oh, wait, not yet. Yeah, this is basically just a warm-up because... we're going to be seeing another form of Metroid really soon. Okay, take care of that one. Okay, there we go. Yeah, we're going to be... We're running into another Metroid really soon. Okay, lava's going down. Not going down just yet, so... Let's see, we're probably going to be going up next. Yeah, I'm going a little bit too high. Better go down and then make myself go up. So yeah, it's actually going down, then go up to the hallway. So yeah, just a little bit more. Yeah, a little bit. Yeah, I definitely want to go up. Yeah, I don't think I'm supposed to, but I know that I'm supposed to definitely wall jump through here, but I do need to collect something else. No, I think I'm okay here, so I definitely need to go down. Let's see. I'm making a Nickelodeon fanfic about As Told by Ginger and Rugrats going to the real world to meet me. Would you read it? That would be interesting. I've actually never had a fanfic written about me, so that'd be interesting. So maybe I'll read it. I'll have to see if you know, whenever you're finished, maybe I'll take a quick glance at it sometime in the future. Not really much of a fanfic reader, but yeah, should be really interesting. Yeah, I can't go down there just yet because lava's not all the way down, so alright, I guess I definitely do need to go up then. Thought I missed something here. Can't go up, can't go down. Should I go left or should I go right? Let me try to see if I can go left now. Oh, that's right. Now that I have the space jump boots, now I can finally go in here. Yeah, ordinarily, if you don't have the space jump boots, it's a bit tricky to get up here. But yeah, I can get this missile. Let me know in the chat if you want me to continue playing through the game. If not, I can just probably stop right now and I can probably just maybe call it another day. Starting to get a little hungry here. I haven't even had my dinner yet. Okay, now that I'm done with that part. Yeah, I definitely want to go down, because I'm all the way towards, like, the beginning area. Yeah, it definitely looks a lot different than when we first started. Yeah, I'm going to grab my. Alright, let me just go check on my phone for a quick second. I think it might be fully charged. Okay, I think my phone is fully charged, so I can definitely see through the chat much easier. Okay, I definitely want to go left. You want me to continue with the game? Okay, I'll continue then. What's my favorite restaurant? Oh man, that's a good question. I really don't go to a lot of restaurants because it's, you know, it's getting pretty pricey nowadays just to go out. Every time that I do go out, it's considered to be like a luxury. But yeah, I guess the most recent restaurant I went to was the Bonefish Grill, and that was really good. Occasionally I would go maybe to Olive Garden or maybe to Chili's. My family and I, we always go to Chili's whenever we're celebrating a birthday because, they have the, like, $2 for $20 meals and we get to share with one another. Not to mention that, there's also the case in which they have those molten lava cakes, and we always have that as like a birthday cake, which is always really good because those things are delicious. Let's see. I don't really go to Red Lobster, even though that I live in Florida. I don't really eat seafood. Although when I went over to Joe's Crab Shack with my friend the other day, their fish and chips were really good. The Benihana is also really good, too. I really love Japanese steakhouses. I already went through here. I want to go up now. Yeah, I'm supposed to go up. Yeah, because you can't go through this door yet unless you do something that's a lot later in the game. But, other than, let's see, if there's any other restaurants I can think of. Not really much, I mean, let's see, there was this one time I went over to, what was the place again? The Melting Pot, that's what it was called, The Melting Pot. The Melting Pot is a place around, I don't remember where the Melting Pot is at, but it's a fondue place, and they have really good fondue. The only problem is that it's really, really expensive. Let's see. We went through there. I think I need to go down and to the left. I think I missed a door. I think it's this way. Yes. I already went through there. But what's down there? I think I may need to go down there. Alright, I'll save right now. But yeah, those are the only restaurants that I really like going to. I don't really go to a lot of breakfast places because, I mean, I don't mind IHOPs or Denny's, but I'm not really much of a breakfast person. So, yeah. Those are the ones I can think of. Yeah, I know I've already been through here, but I'm going to check one particular room. Yeah, it's a little bit more that way. I want to see if I missed something, like a power-up. No, I don't think so. I think I already went. Maybe I wasn't supposed to go left, I was supposed to go right. Let me look through my map again. Let's see. Okay, maybe I'll try going through that area right over there. Let me just make a marker. Try going through here. Alright, here we go. Yeah, but I'm trying to look through places that I haven't been to yet because I want to continue throughout the game. My apologies, everybody. I haven't played through this game in so long. The last time I played through the game was like months ago, and I haven't been playing ever since because I want to be able to finish off my content. I was really going through, some tough times with my dad being in the hospital and all, but I don't have a lot of time to play games or to, you know, do anything else other than work, but... Yeah, but one of the very few times in which I can just relax and play some games, it's always a lot of fun. Okay, let's see. I believe Phineas and Ferb should air in 1996 on Nickelodeon because Dexter's Laboratory, because popular and last year of Ren and Stimpy, I believe it fits the gap of, it fits both of these gaps. Phineas and Ferb in the 90s, I guess it would be kind of interesting, but I don't know. I think that where Phineas and Ferb, the time that it did air, I think it was fine the way it was. But, Phineas and Ferb in the 90s would have been interesting. I don't know if it would have fit really well when it came out, but, you know, at that point, it doesn't really matter since, it came out when it did. So, I'm glad that it did come out eventually. Okay. Should be almost where I was supposed to be at. Okay, I made it. Oh, I was supposed to go down. Oh well, there we go. So, now we can continue on with the game. Okay. Okay, new area. Great. Finally, something a little bit different to look at. Oh, I just unexpectedly killed an enemy. Yeah, if you remember these enemies from Metroid Fusion, well, then again, there's a lot of enemies of Metroid Fusion in this game because, if you recall, Metroid Fusion's ship was basically just SR388, the habitat of SR388. Okay, now let me just go through this mine really quick. Yeah, because you're actually supposed to ride through this thing, but because it's been damaged, you can't go through it. So just... Okay, so yeah, you can actually ride through this one. So here we go. Oh, I need to take that thing down, so I will be right back. Okay, there we go. There we go. Okay. Continue. Okay. you're done. Yep, there's definitely some Metroids here. There are two of them. Alright, and I don't see a save state. Saving place. You need to be really careful because these things will actually slow your momentum down. Oh, there it is! Ow! Okay, ending up. There we go. Okay, let's go to the next one. Okay, there's one to the right. Oh, it slowed me down. I gotta get out, Okay, there we go. Yeah, I really need the gravity suit. Oh, there you are. I'm floating! Okay, there we go. We're done here. Okay, the lava should be going down. Just a little bit, but that's okay. There's definitely more Metroids around here. Did you hear about the passing of the actor who voiced Susie's dad in Rugrats? No, I'm sorry. I have not. And if that is the case, then I'm very sorry. Yeah, that's really tragic. Hey, Patricia, I'm back. Hey, Pocketbook, welcome back. What happened while I was gone? What's your progress? Well, I killed a few more Metroids. I got the speed booster, and I got the space jump. I got the spacer beam, and right now I'm about... I have about 28 Metroids to kill, and I'm in the mining area. So, yeah, still got plenty of gameplay left. Okay, let's see. Alright, so heading up. So here. Yeah, let's see if there's anywhere else to explore. I think you need to explore a little bit more to the left, around here. No, I think I'm okay.
Yeah, this place is pretty short. Let me just restore for the last checkpoint. There we go. We just restored ourselves to the last save state, so we didn't have to go through all that again. So I'm going to head out of here, and I think I'm going to head over to the next area. I think the lava from the last place we were at, I think it's completely gone, so I think it'll be a lot easier for me to travel. Did you hear about the Jimmy Neutron reboot? I've been hearing a lot of rumors about a possible Jimmy Neutron reboot for quite a while, but I don't know if it's 100% confirmed yet. So, if there is a possible Jimmy Neutron reboot, then, you know, I'm probably not going to go too crazy about it because I mean, it was okay, but I never really was a huge Jimmy Neutron fan. Gonna try. Let's see. I believe that because we already killed a few Metroid, I want to try to see if maybe that part has already been cleared out. So I'm gonna try going to the left. It is gone. Right, new area now. And by the way, I really hate those things. Got some more Metroids coming in. There are six of them. I don't know why these creatures look like birds, but I kind of find it pretty humorous. Okay. Let's see. Let me just check through the chat. Okay. Alright. Now we've entered a new area. Now we need to turn on the lights here. Oh, of course I fell down. Why wouldn't I? Get up, get up. Yep.
Here we go. Yeah, there's definitely a... Oh yeah, I remember this place. Oh, we're gonna have a new... We're gonna be fighting another new Metroid now, so hooray! We're gonna be fighting off against, I believe, the Beta Metroid, so... Joy! Yep. Okay, here we go. Yeah, you think this thing is hard? The Omega Metroid's gonna be even harder. I might even die like 20 times. But this thing is faster, it shoots out acid. You just need to dodge its attacks. It takes a lot more missiles. Uh-oh, I'm probably gonna be dead. Yep, I'm dead. There's a Nickelodeon show that should have been on Cartoon Network and vice versa. That's a really good question. Nickelodeon show for Cartoon Network. Not sure exactly. Oh, second time's the charm! Perfect. Let's see. Pay attention next time. I'm probably not even gonna fight until I have at least full health, so I'm not gonna be fighting this thing for now. Yeah, I'll probably fight one of the more easier Metroids. You know, I'm wondering that, you know, because this thing is full of spikes, how do any creatures go through here? Get out! Anyway, I'm sorry about that, Funkabug. Anyway, so I'm going answering your question. Nickelodeon shows that should have been on Cartoon Network. I don't know. It's kind of hard to say because, you know, Nickelodeon and Cartoon Network are different enough that they have their own unique styles that they're very well known for. Like, I mean, you know, I would have been surprised if something like Danny Phantom or Avatar could have been on Cartoon Network. Or, you know, something like, something like, you know, Chowder or The Misadventures of Flapjack could have been on Nickelodeon. So, yeah, it's, as for if they should have been there, I really couldn't tell you. I feel like, you know, where the cartoons were, I feel like, you know, they're okay with where they should have been. I mean, I'm sure that maybe they would have been treated differently. Like, I mean, I can't even imagine Nickelodeon picking up Adventure Time. That would have been so interesting, but... Yeah. I'll probably fight the Zeta Metroid a little bit later. Because trust me, I'm sure that... We'll be getting into it down the line, but I want to see if maybe I can try to, maybe turn on the factory. Oh yeah, I'm back here again, aren't I? Going up. Oh, that should be a lot easier now. Okay, now I want to try to see if I can get that missile. No, it's this way. Up and around. Oh, no, no, okay, now I remember. There it is. Okay, there we go. Aw, oh, great, another Zeta Metroid. Oh, that's what I needed. Okay, let's see if maybe this additional E-Tank can help me out. But I don't think so because I'm in the dark! I can't even see anything. Yes! I did it! Probably can't find a... Need to find a safe state right now. Oh, thank you.
Yes.
Okay, we're back where we were. Okay. Let's see if we can try this Zeta Metroid again. Yeah, you can't go in here unless you have the power bomb, which I do not have the power bomb, so I'm not going to be up there for quite a while. Ah, yes. Okay. Okay, let's see if I can
find it. Worst Nicktoon episode I've ever seen. Let's see. There's been a lot of episodes of Ren and Stimpy that really got me frustrated when I started rewatching it again for 3 original Nicktoons month. I remember when I was a kid, one of my least favorite episodes was when they were trying to reenact the Pinocchio story, similar to how in the first season, you know, that they did a lot of parodies of fairy tales, like they did Robin Hood, and they did they did The Littlest Giant, but then there was one on Pinocchio, and that really irritated me when I was a kid. And rewatching it again, I remembered why. And also the Wild Thornberrys episode, Eliza Ecology, that really, really pissed me off, because it's the perfect example on why the Wild Thornberrys doesn't work. Because when she tries to help out the other animals, she pretty much destroys the entire food chain. Oh, I gotta fight this boss now. So, be right back. Now that I got that done, I can be able to take this down. Yeah, alright. I didn't think I was gonna take it down like that so easily. Alright, so, yeah, I really didn't like that episode of the Wild Thornberrys, and I guess, you know, the classic example that everybody seems to bring up, like Arnold betrays Iggy. A lot of people really, really do not like that episode. And let's see. And, you know, with Avatar, you know, like the Fire The Great Divide, that's what it is, The Great Divide. And, yeah, many people really don't like that episode. But, yeah, there's a lot of episodes of, you know, Nicktoons that I really don't like. Maybe sometime in the future I'll definitely do a list on that. I mean, there's a lot of episodes of Best Told by Ginger that I really, really do not like. I'm definitely going to be doing my top 10 worst As Told by Ginger's episode list definitely next year. You can count on that. Alright, let's try that again.
There's a lot of episodes of SpongeBob from seasons 5 through 9 that a lot of people hate. Yeah, I do know about the hate that those episodes of SpongeBob get. SpongeBob gets. Sorry. I really haven't seen enough. I mean, I have seen, you know, SpongeBob, especially when I had to do the Nickelodeon tribute, but I haven't really seen, enough of those SpongeBob episodes that really stuck into my mind. Mostly because that, you know, as much as I really do respect SpongeBob, SpongeBob is not really in my forte. I mean, I was already 13 when that show aired, so. Let's see this. Alright, I'm gonna try this again. Okay, here we go. I'm definitely gonna die in this one. Yeah. Okay, let's see. There's a season 8 episode called Demolition Doofus where Mrs. Puff enters SpongeBob into a demolition derby, hoping that he'll die. Wow. That sounds pretty messed up. Favorite Nickelodeon dad? Ooh, that's a really good question because I think I did a list a long time ago about my top 5 favorite Nicktoons dads, and I chose Iroh from Avatar The Last Airbender, and I guess I shouldn't have because, you know, technically he's not a dad. I mean, he is a father figure for Zuko, but yeah, I wouldn't really call him like the best Nickelodeon dad. I probably need to redo that list in the future, but I did listed other dads like, Pete and Pete's dad, there was Stu, and I probably need to redo that list again sometime in the future. Yeah, but yeah, there really aren't a lot of dads in Nickelodeon that really stick out to me because they all portray themselves as the stereotypical goofy dads, so yeah, I probably need to do some more insight into what I consider to be like a great Nickelodeon dad because I guess Stu would probably be one that I can think of that is a really good dad. I mean, even though that he's goofy at times, but
You can definitely tell that he really cares about his sons, Tommy and Dill. Anyway, so yeah, I mean, I get that Mrs. Puff is getting sick and tired of training SpongeBob, you know, for getting his body license, but seriously, wanting to have SpongeBob dead, I mean, that's kind of messed up. Alright, let me just take a quick breather for just a quick second. There has to be somewhere I can get some help. From the looks of it, I don't think so. Nah, not really. In fact, yeah. Not really a lot of places to get health around here. I can't even find a save state. Yeah, I think I may need to fight this one on my own. Yeah, for this particular boss, what you have to do is that you have to shoot around its protective shield layers, and you have to shoot from inside the core with the spacer beam. But the problem is that because it shoots a lot of missiles and it shoots a lot of lasers, it's pretty hard to get yourself situated so you can be able to take it down. Also, these particular things right here, that these platforms that pretty much move up and move down, it doesn't make things a lot easier. Yeah. Okay. There are really a lot of bad episodes of SpongeBob seasons 5 through 9. Demolition Doofus is even close to the worst episode. If you watch those seasons, you'll definitely have more than enough episodes for a top 10 worst SpongeBob episodes list. Maybe, but I'm not really interested in doing that particular list. Mostly because I know that everybody else has pretty much done a SpongeBob list already, so I'll let them take care of it. As for me, I'd rather be discussing about shows that really don't get discussed a lot of when it comes to Nickelodeon shows. I'm going to take a break from this boss because I think I do need to be a little bit stronger. I'll probably take down the remaining Metroids, so yeah, we'll be right back. We're gonna take down another one of the Metroids. Oh! Another Zeta Metroid! Perfect! Thank you.
There we go.
Okay. You never watch Ren and Stimpy hunting episode. It was banned on Nickelodeon. Go to a party cartoon and fishing episode too. Hunting episode. I probably already seen it if there was an adult party cartoon. Okay. Yeah, I definitely want to save here. I need some more energy. Oh wait, this is where the... I think I'm okay here because this is where the, yeah, I'm okay here. Yeah, better not fall down because if I fall down, I have to redo the whole fight all over again. Okay, there we go. Okay, just need two more Metroids to go, and there's that Zeta Metroid, and I believe the other one is a, could be an Alpha Metroid, I'm not sure. I think it's a Gamma Metroid. Okay, going up. Okay, let me just take a quick save. Okay, what is the worst episode of Adult Party Cartoon? Ren Seeks Help, definitely. That episode really made me feel uncomfortable, mostly because seeing the abuse of that of those animals, and also it just made it really cringeworthy when, you know, that scene in which Stimpy was, I mean, Ren was talking about, like, when he met Stimpy for the first time, in which he constantly hit him. I mean, don't get me wrong, don't get me wrong, I really do respect other people's opinions, but I really don't agree with what Thad said, in which he called it, like, a dark, underrated masterpiece. I'm sorry, Thad, it isn't. It's really uncomfortable to watch. But yeah, there's a lot of episodes of pretty much every, and then also, Stimpy is pregnant. Oh my god, I remember when I first saw that. I think it was online, because I don't think that episode ever aired on TV. So when I first saw that, I was like, wow, this is really uncomfortable. I think I even remember my cousin was even sharing a picture or maybe a gift in which it was Ren and Stimpy and they were chopping down logs, and Ren put a saw right around his crotch area and Stimpy had the log like around his butt area, and it made it look like they were humping. And then my cousin was saying, like, this is what we grew up with, ladies and gentlemen. And I'm like, no, man. This is the adult party cartoon version. That's not the Ren and Stimpy version that we grew up with. So, yeah, you're mistaken. Yeah, I mean, the fact that they even did an abortion joke, wow, that was really uncomfortable. Okay, so I have one more Metroid to take down. You know, at this point, I think I am going to take down that last Metroid as opposed to fighting the boss, because I'm pretty much going to take down the boss in the end. But I do need to take care of this last Metroid, so I'm going to go take care of it right now. That is, if I don't die first. Yeah, this is a really cool statue, by the way. It looks like there's these two Chozo soldiers holding some sort of globe. I mean, it really makes things interesting. It's like, you really want to know what happened with the Chozo. Did they when they disappeared all those years ago? It's like, I know it explains some parts in the Metroid manga, but there are some things I really want to know more about. Like, there's some parts of the story that never really got fully explained, and unfortunately, because Nintendo doesn't want to release Metroid Dread, and instead wanted to do Metroid Other M, they pretty much just killed the franchise until we got Federation Force, which, I mean, I haven't played Federation Force, so I don't know what that's like, but I don't think it's that bad as everybody made it out to be. But trust me, I think if it wasn't for the fact that another Metroid 2 remake came out, I think, you know, fans of the series would have been pretty disappointed. Let's take it out of there. Yeah, this place is pretty difficult considering that there's now spikes, and he doesn't get hurt. It's like, great, thank you. I'm gonna try to use this my advantage. Nope, of course not. You god! Okay, that's the last one. Ouch. Okay. What are your expectations for the Legends of the Hidden Temple movie based on what you've seen so far? Well, I don't know about how the story of the kids are, but the way that the temple looks, it looks really cool. That's all I have to say. It looks really cool. It looks definitely more like a more updated, more bigger budget version of how the game show was with its temple run. So, yeah, it looks really cool. Okay. Alright, now I need to save so I can be able to take down that boss. Because that's what I have to do next. Okay, let's hope I can win. Okay, I really do need to take down that boss, so yeah, I'm gonna probably go through here later. Even though that the lava path has already been cleared, I really do need to take down that boss, and I'm getting myself killed over here. Okay. Oh, wait, that's not the right way. Have I heard of the 2000 back at the barnyard? No, I have not. Considering that Barnyard came out in 2007 and the movie and the TV series came out in 2008, I didn't even know that there was a 2000 Barnyard pilot. So yeah, that's a new one on me. Wait, where am I going? I'm supposed to take down the boss, I'm not supposed to be here. Hmm.
Did I click something? It's been lagging. Oh, I'm very sorry if it has. I haven't really been noticing. Yeah, sorry everybody if it's been lagging. It's probably getting late, and I think I'm expecting rain tonight, so maybe that's why it's lagging. If that's the case, I sincerely apologize. Okay, let's try this again. Hopefully I can win. Okay, let's try this again. Alright, I wanted to double check to see if I can get back up there, but I can't. Here we go again. Thank you. I was really close on that, too. Let's see.
Okay. No questions yet. Okay, I'll try that again.
Alright, I think I'm gonna have to call it a day. I'm starting to get a little bit tired. Alright, so guys, I'm gonna have to call it. So thank you so much for joining. I'll probably do this another time, so I'll catch you later.